हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल एस एस स्टडी टेक। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन पोस्टमैन कलेक्शंस एज पार्ट ऑफ पोस्टमैन बिगिनर ट्यूटोरियल्स। एंड दिस सेशन इज वेरी यूजफुल फॉर बिगिनर्स हु वांटेड टू लर्न द पोस्टमैन कलेक्शंस। एंड इन केस इफ यू आर न्यू टू दिस चैनल, प्लीज डू सब्सक्राइब। एंड टुडेज एजेंडा इज सो वॉट इज द पोस्टमैन कलेक्शंस, हाउ टू क्रिएट अ पोस्टमैन कलेक्शन, हाउ डू वी एड अ रिक्वेस्ट एंड फोल्डर्स टू कलेक्शन, इम्पोर्ट एंड एक्सपोर्ट द कलेक्शन, duplicating the collection and removing the collection from the workspace, deleting the collection, how to add a comment to the collections. So let's see one by one. So what is a postman collection? So postman collection is nothing but a container, or we can say it's a folder of a group of postman requests. And in a simple terminology, I can say that it's an aggregation of group of postman requests. And it is very useful when we are working with an organization under a same application. Application has a bunch of requests, and to organize them, we need a collection. So collection help us to organize a group of requests. And this is very helpful when we are trying to run all the requests at once. So collection can help us to run all the requests at once. And we can share this application, I mean, we can share this collection with other team members by using a JSON, or we can use some hosted URLs from the Postman server. This is a simple introduction about the Postman collection. So let's see how we create this Postman collection in the Postman tool. Let me open my Postman standalone application. So once we are into a Postman collection, so when we go to this files, in the header section, we have files. So under files, we have a new. So under new, we have a building blocks like requests, collections, and environment. So we will create a collection here. So click on collection, and in this new window, we can get this as a create a new collection, and I will name this collection as session one. And we do have some options for this collections to create, like adding a description. I can say this is my first collection, and we do have some authorization. So when we are working with team, we can provide some authorization so that they can use the same authorizations. Like we do have some types here. So we have basic authentication by using username and password. We do have some barrier tokens, and we have some prerequisite scripts. So we can write the scripts, and we have a test here. So we can write the test conditions, and we have some variables. We can write the collection variables here. So for now, I added a description and created a collection name as session one, and let's create this collection. So once I created this collection, so in the left explorer section of this application, we have some history, collections, API. So I already created one collection. So that collection will be stored into my collections option. So you can see sessions one is created. So till now we have created a collection, and we created a only empty collection. We need to add some requests into this collection. So we'll add a request. So once we select this sessions one request, which we created just now, and go to this three dots, which says view more actions. So once we click on this option, we will see some menu items, which is add request. So click on this add request. And we can see a save request dialog coming up, and we need to say the request name, like demo one is a request name. And I can provide some any kind of description, like I am testing or developing. Yeah. And if you scroll down a little more, you can see select a collection or a folder. So currently it's already selected a collection, which is a session one. In case if you wanted to change the collection, you can directly go to this back option, and you can select the collections. So I am selecting session one, and save to session one collection. So once I save, I can see this request coming up in the collection. And now I will create another collection, I mean another request under the same collection. So go to view more actions. Under view more actions, this time I will go to add a folder, and I will name this as folder name as a get services. And we can give this description for this folder, and we can provide some authorization, prerequisites, tests. And for now, I am just creating, I am storing the get services here. So this is a folder. I given get service as a folder name and description, and let's create. So I created a folder here, and once we have this folder created, we already created one request, which is a demo one. I can simply place this demo one into this get services request, or I can create another request by clicking on the view more actions for this folder, and I can add a request here, and my request name is demo2, and click on save to get services folder. So once I save, I can see my new request has been in the get services folder. So for simplification, just I will go and add another folder. Let's say post request, and simple description, post request here. Click on create. So I will drag this request into this post request folder. So here we can see the get services has one request and the post service has one request. Let me change this to post. So till now we have seen how we created a collection and added a request into collection and created a folders into a collections. Now let's see how do we import and export this collections. So we need to go to any collection, I click on the collections and again go to the view more actions. Under this we have an option called export. So once I click on export, it gives me some recommendations and some versions. So mostly it gives us some recommended version, like collection version 2.1, and we do have some other versions too. So I will prefer using a recommended version, and I click this option and click on export. So I will export into one of my folder. So I exported this collection. Now let me show you where is my collection. So here in downloads I have this collection, and this collection is in the JSON format. In the introduction I have given information that we can share this collection using a JSON. So this is in the format of JSON. And how do we import the same collection into our Postman? So let's go to option. Here we have a import. So in the header section we have an import option, and go to import. We have file, folder, link, raw text and code repository. So currently it is a file, so it's a JSON file, and I click this option as a file and go to this upload files, and I will select this collection which I imported. Click on open, and here we have a sessions one and Postman collection 2.1, and it's a collection, and I will say import. So here we have another collection which is added, which is a collection one copy, because it's already we have a session one, and it's also imported collection is a session one, so that is the reason it is added a copy. So in this way we can import and export the collections. And let's see how we can duplicate the collection. So once we select any collection and go to this three dots, which is in view more action, under that we have an option called duplicate. So once I click on duplicate, I can see another collection created, which is a copy two. So this is how we can create a duplication of this collections. And we see another option, like how do we delete the collections. So currently I am working on my workspace. When it comes to the team workspace, so we need to very cautious while deleting this collections or the request. So in the team we cannot delete directly, because a team approver or one who is managing all this collection can only delete. Team members can only do a maintenance activity on the collections. So let's say I'll go to this session one copy two, and I will go to this view more actions. Once I click on this view more action, here we have an option called remove from the workspace. So once I click on this option, remove from the workspace, because this is not shared with other team members, it is saying that I can delete directly without removing the workspace. Let's cancel this request. In case if we are sharing that request with other team members, then you can delete, you can remove from your workspace. Let's go to this option and go to delete. So once I click on delete, it gives me delete collections, and it gives me some instruction that you are wanted to delete this collection. Yes, and click on delete option. So our collection has been deleted. So this is how we can delete the collection and remove from the workspace. And I will show you how we can add a comment to our collection. So just click on this collection, and under that collection, go to again view more actions. This time go to the option where we have this button. So which is says arrow button. So once I click on this arrow button, it gives me some collection information. It gives API, share, run, and Vivin browser, and Vivin web browser. So click on Vivin web. So it will route us to the Chrome browser. And it gives me the same kind of collection environment here. So I do have the two collection, I mean collection has a two services. So for the session one and the get services folder, and a demo 2, and I can add a comment by using a comments here. I can say I am testing or developing. Add comment. So in this way we can add a comments to our collections. So far we have discussed what is a Postman collection, how do we create collections and adding a request and adding a folders into collection, how to import and export the collection, how do we duplicate the collections and removing the collection from the workspace, deleting the collections, how do we add comments to the collection. I hope this session is very useful for you, and in case if you like this video, please do like and share, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel SS Study Tech. Thank you.